of influencers.
And you used the money for a new company?
So I essentially spent all of that money on the second startup, which was called Frey, which was like a buyer-powered marketplace for local services, which means that, you know, if you need requests kind of with painting, like the office or something, you could place that request and you could say like, hey, I need a painter to come in and I'm willing to pay like $250. Most marketplaces are the other way around, right?
Yeah.
So this was like a buyer-powered marketplace where the buyer had the control to say like, okay, this is what I'm willing to pay for a service like this, which is something we now know as, for instance, Werkspot in Holland. Or Peerby. You know, Peerby is more like lending, but I think they kind of morphed into that model where you can also kind of purchase services. So we used all of that money to kind of spend it in that second startup, which is also where most of it got lost.
So you failed on that one?
Yep.
What happened? What did you do wrong?
When you're building a two-sided marketplace, you need a lot of money to grow both ends of the marketplace. So you need people who offer their services, but at the same time, you need customers. If you don't have those two, you know, it's kind of the chicken and egg problem that you hear a lot about. If you don't have any, you know, any one of those sides, the entire marketplace doesn't work. And acquiring customers when, you know, you have limited funds is super, super hard. And then, you know, added complexity is also that you need a very high volume of transactions in order to make the model work. Right, so if a lot of people are requesting, okay, I need a paint job for $10, and our business model was like, okay, we would make like 10% of that, you know, imagine how many kind of jobs people need to post in order to have that model kind of, you know, return sufficient amounts in order to be able to sustain it, and that's where we failed.
How did you feel after failing?
Not any different than today.
No?
No.
So you weren't depressed or something?
No.
Or you didn't thought shit?
No, I don't believe in that shit.
No?
No.
They say you can only build a good business when you failed once. Is that true?
I think you need to fail a few more times. But And maybe that's a bit of the Dutch mentality, right? That a lot of people, they think about failing and they think it's the worst kind of thing there is. Mm-hmm. You know, here we almost celebrate failure, which means that, you know, we try out a bunch of different things. Today we launched an entirely kind of new concept called like the Circle Marketplace. And we launch new features almost every week. Some of them, they fail miserably. Others, they succeed. But we've probably, you know, changed our business model 20 times in the 4 or 5 years that we've been around. So it's just, it's if you're launching a new business and you're taking extreme risk, you know, and you want to reap very high rewards, you also need to have a mindset where you don't think about failure too much or the consequences of failure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
The Moti on Instagram, Facebook, and Snapchat.